If it isn't broken, don't fix it. But why is the professor taking all this apart if there's no oil leak? Because I wanted to make this video for you, especially if your Honda or Acura has this engine and it's leaking oil. I dig myself into all this trouble to show you everything so you can fix your Honda oil leak once and for all. By the way, this is the longest video I have ever made. Even though the job is simple, there is so much to unpack to do it right. In the end, if this video can reach thousands of people and save you each a few hundred bucks, it will be worth all my effort. Let's dive into it now. Welcome to Professor's Garage. Appreciate you watching this video, and I promise not to waste a second of your precious time. But if you found this video to be helpful, consider giving us a thumbs up and subscribing to the channel. Without further ado, let's get to the problem. If you have a Honda or Acura, chances are you have the J35 engine. I'm going to provide a long list of models and years with this engine on the screen and in the description below. This engine has VTEC for variable timing, and two gaskets inside the VTEC solenoid are prone to leak, especially when your car is aged. While your engine's valve cover gasket may also be responsible for the problem, all your leaks from VTEC might be overlooked or misdiagnosed because of its location. In short, this is one of the most common oil leaks on Honda vehicles, but the good news is it's relatively straightforward and cost-effective to fix the problem. The parts are only $10 or so, but you need to pay attention to details and follow the procedure to the teeth to get this done successfully. And I've gone through 4 iterations of this replacement to show you everything for the job. So let's work on it, and I will draw your attention to these details along the way. There is a lot to unpack. The solution to your VTEC solenoid oil leak, or almost any oil leak, is to replace the sealing gaskets. However, on some models, Honda does not offer these gaskets separately, and we can only purchase the entire solenoid in one piece. If you have the budget, you can spend hundreds of dollars on it and replace the whole unit, which requires taking apart the air intake and valve cover and is rather involved. Or, as some people do, purchase the unit, take it apart, get the gaskets inside, and follow the procedure I'm about to show you to replace them. This way, you essentially spend hundreds of dollars for 2 OE gaskets. If your budget allows it, go for it. OE parts are always the best. Now, step back. The problem with existing gaskets is because they are aged. So before you even attempt to replace them, you may consider AT205 to rejuvenize the gaskets. Simply pour it into your engine. It mixes with the engine oil and can travel to these gaskets to hopefully extend their life. This is the easiest method, and if it works, you can delay this job for a couple of years. The best solution, however, is to replace the gaskets with new ones, and you will have the peace of mind. Because Honda doesn't sell these gaskets on certain models, you can only purchase aftermarket parts, which are inexpensive but not guaranteed to work. In fact, I have already replaced these gaskets twice. First time in 2019, 5 years ago, which lasted 2 years only. And the second time in 2021, which has held up very well in the last 3 years. I have no oil leak whatsoever on this Honda Odyssey for now, but I have seen so many tutorials without clear instructions or where it's done incorrectly. So I purchased 2 sets of new gaskets to show you the replacement procedure and hopefully make your job easy and successful. So let's work on it, and I will draw your attention to key details along the way. First thing is to vacuum and make sure there's no dust, because the last thing you want is to get dust into the component. Also, it's very important for the engine to cool down before you start the job. If the car has been driven, let it sit there for hours and completely cool down before you attempt this job. As I said, this replacement itself is relatively simple. You replace the gasket, put it back, and the job is done. In this package, it includes 2 sets. Now you see there are a number of connectors, and the rack is in the way, so we need to remove them. First, the connector to the solenoid. Press and pull it up. and the connector to the oil pressure sensor. Again, press it, pull it out. The PCB hose. Remove the clamp. And you may have to, if this is the first time, you probably have to wiggle it before you can pull and remove it. Now connectors to the coil pack. Again, press and then pull up. If it's difficult to do so, you may use a screwdriver. Press it on top, pull it up. Press, pull, press, pull. Now on the other side, this is the EGR connector. Again, press it and then pull. Now two more connectors, two down there. One, two. You don't need to remove the oil cap, but I'm removing it to show you a better angle. For this connector, the tab is in the front, right here. Press it and then pull it up. Hear the sound? And then once you hear the sound, it disengage and then pull it up. Yeah. For this one, the tab is on the side. Press the top, disengage, and then try to pull it up at the same time. Yes. Okay, press the tab here and then pull it up. One more thing. So grab two sides of it and then try to pull it out. There are two tabs like this on this rack. Put it down like this. And then you can remove it. Now you can remove this. Put it aside. And you will have access to the solenoid. You may want to simply tighten this to secure it. 10 millimeter. Actually, I still want to remove this piece. Slowly pour it. Remove the oil dipstick. Pay attention here because there are exactly three bolts you want to remove. Okay, and they are on top. One here and two down there. Take them off. One, two. And the one at the top, which is longer. Now you can remove the solenoid. There will be two dowel pins. Be careful, don't lose them. Wiggle a little bit. Hopefully you can pull it straight up. But be super careful because you see there's one dowel pin here. It can be attached to your solenoid when you remove it. So either way, make sure it's there. Now the other one I think is actually on my fingertip. Let me show you. This is aluminum, so if you lose it somewhere, you may not get it back. Now you can take a closer look and see the groove. This is for the gasket, and so if gasket is not here, it is right there. And that's one gasket you want to remove. Because the pin is there, and let me zoom in. I would like to remove the pin first, if I could. Put it aside, secure it, okay? Don't lose it. We are going to use picks. I prefer a plastic. Because with plastic, you are not going to damage anything. Because if you scratch it, if you make a damage, it's guaranteed it's going to leak. Don't do that. They are sturdy enough to remove the gaskets, but they are not too strong to damage anything. And then there is this metal plate. And under this plate, there's another gasket. That's why there are two gaskets. You may need something to pry from the back, so if it gets stuck. The gasket sticks to it. That's why there is some resistance. For this particular model, Honda does not sell the original gasket. I will grab a piece of shop towel and then spray the carbon cleaner to it and then use the towel to clean it toward the outside. Now let's pay our attention to the components that we have removed. Again, there is one dowel pin. There's another. Don't lose it. Make sure they exactly match the original ones.
lubricate gaskets with engine oil, and that will make sure this will go back smoothly, right? It's not going to pinch. Looks good. The same for the other gasket. So this is the top and bottom two bolts. The other dowel pin does not stick to the solenoid. I'm going to just individually install this back onto the engine so it stays there. Put this dowel pin back on. The new gasket.
Now this is super important. Make sure the gasket has the exact fit. This gasket right here does not, and is a little bit oversized. But I went ahead anyway to test it, and sure enough, it starts to leak when the engine is warmed up. If this is your case, try another gasket right here and make sure it's 100% fit. And then follow the rest of my procedure, because the only problem in this attempt is the gasket itself.
So, also good we have a pin here to hold this in place. So let's put it back. I will let the pin go in first, and then the other one. Three bolts, you know, the long one at the top, and then the other two at the bottom. So we are going to thread. And then the one at the top. And then back to the bottom. The other one at the bottom. And thread everything first. Because the last thing you want is to cross thread. And these bolts do not hold lots of torque. But do not use any power tool here. This is a 1/4-inch drive, very small. And with this, as long as you just turn it here, you're not going to over torque. Now I switch to my small torque wrench. There are two bolts here. Start with one of those. First, this one at the bottom, go to the top, come back to the bottom, and then continue. The torque will be 8 Nm or 6 ft-lbs, 72 inch-lbs. It's important to follow this sequence so that you have an even distribution of the pressure. Okay, so just gradually tighten it down. Good. Good. Great. That's it. Now put the dipstick back, and while you're here, take a measurement of the oil level. Now we're going to put everything back. Just make them snug. Again, there's a tap here, and then there is another tap. So make sure they are aligned. Push in. EGR connector. Just push it in. Now the two connectors in the front. Push in, so this stays in place. So everything is connected back. We can start the engine. If there is oil leak, you are going to see it. Unfortunately, it started to leak after the engine warmed up. That was last night. When I put on the first set, the gasket under the plate was a bit too tight.
Now I repeat the process to put the old gaskets back. I followed the same procedure. The only difference was the gaskets. And this time, there was no leak in the end. You can watch this a second time or skip to the end for a summary of the tips.
So look at this. Hopefully you can see it. This sticks out a little bit. It doesn't go in completely. So I was trying to push one side in, and then the other side will come out just a little bit.
I'm going to try the other set. If this portion of the gasket is still not a good fit, I'm going to go back to the previous gasket that I took out.
This gasket that I replaced 5 years ago, they're still pliable. These are not good. So these old gaskets will go back. Now we are putting back the gasket.
And I can tell you, I immediately feel the difference. This gasket, it fits exactly. Because when you push one side in, you don't want the other side to come out. This is going to create a tight seal, and that's what you need. So again, double check everything is connected back and then nothing is in the way of the moving parts. So all looks good and I'm going to start the engine. We'll let it warm up and then make sure there's no leak. I feel rather confident.
So far so good, I don't see anything.
The engine has been running for 15 minutes. The radiator vents came on and off multiple times already. There is no surprise. So we are all good.
So there you have it. You have fixed the oil leak with $10 parts. And here is a recap of what you need to pay attention to. Number one, purchase the gaskets from more than one aftermarket sources. You see only one worked for me and you can find the link to it, not a sponsor. Number two, make sure the area is clean when performing the replacement. It helps to vacuum it. Number three, do this job when the engine is completely cold or you may over-torque. Number four, when removing the assembly, be careful with the dowel pins and don't lose them. Number five, now this is super important, test fit of the gaskets. If they do not fit completely, use a different set and hopefully they fit. Number six, lubricate the gaskets before installation. Number seven, tighten the bolts gradually. Follow the sequence for an even distribution and torque them to 6 foot-pounds only. Never go above 10 foot-pound or you may damage the threads. Number eight, finally, nothing else. Do not lubricate the bolts. Never use anti-seize or you will over-torque them and no liquid gasket or whatsoever on the seals. Follow this procedure and I'm confident you will have a success. I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If it empowered you on your DIY car care journey, consider giving us a thumbs up and subscribing to Professor's Garage. Remember, if a professor can do it, you can do it. Until next time, may the Lord bless you and give you peace. 平安.